Hello students, welcome again for another learning bite. Before that, please subscribe my channel to support my effort. Thanks in advance. Today we will learn about electron microscopes, scanning and transmission electron microscopes. Let's begin. Let us see first, why electron microscope? What are the limitations of light microscopes? Light microscope has resolution of around 200 nanometers, or 0.2 micrometers. This means, they can't distinguish two points that are closer than 200 nanometers apart. The practical magnification limit of a light microscope is 1000x. In transmission mode, the thickness of the sample is limited to tens of micrometers. Light microscopes cannot provide in-depth information on the three-dimensional structure of specimen. Because of these limitations, electron microscope is invented. Following are the features of electron microscope. Electron microscopes can resolve features that are more than 1 million times smaller than optical microscopes. Some electron microscopes can detect objects as small as 1/20th of a nanometer. Instead of visible light, electron microscopes use a beam of electrons to illuminate the sample. Electron microscopes use electromagnetic coils to focus electron beam instead of glass lenses. Electron microscopes can be used for diffraction contrast imaging, phase contrast imaging, high-resolution imaging, chemical analysis, and electron diffraction. There are different types of electron microscopes. Scanning electron microscopes, SEM, and transmission electron microscopes, TEM. Let us see where exactly electron microscope is needed. Studying the ultrastructure of cells, microorganisms, and large molecules. To diagnose gastrointestinal tumors,
detect microorganisms in the gastrointestinal tract, and analyze the effects of treatments on patients. Testing new vaccinations and medicines, comparing blood and tissue samples, and identifying diseases and viruses. Researching metals, polymers, batteries, and geological samples. They can also be used to perform quality control and failure analysis. Analyzing gunshot residue, comparing bullet markings, and identifying firearms. So we can see, electron microscopy is a blessing in research. Let's now study the scanning and transmission electron microscopes, one by one. First, the internal structure of scanning electron microscope. It consists of an electron gun, which generates an electron beam, which passes through anode lens first. Then it passes through two condenser and one objective lenses, making it more collimated. This collimated electron beam falls on the sample, kept on a motorized stage, which moves sample up, down or sideways to scan. The electron beam reflects back as three signals: backscattered electrons, X-rays, and secondary electrons, which are received by respective detectors and sent through amplifiers to computer to generate graphical image of the scan. Shown here is the actual image generated by SEM. Let's now study the transmission electron microscope. It also starts with electron gun, which emits electrons, which are then passed through anode to get accelerated. After passing through condenser lens, the collimated electron beam falls on sample, transmitting through the sample. Electron beam passes through few more lenses, and at the end, through projector lens, which projects the electron on the fluorescent screen. Fluorescent screen shows the inside image of the sample. TEM also has three signals to be processed to create actual image: scattered electrons, energy loss electrons, and characteristic X-rays, processing which the actual image is obtained, as shown in the example. So which one is better, SEM or TEM? Let's see the difference between SEM and TEM. SEM samples are easily produced. SEM gives 3D image. Same sample range is from 1 cm to 10 to the power minus 30 nanometers. SEM is used to study surface morphology. While TEM sample requires complex preparations, TEM produces 2D images with range down to 0.1 nanometers. TEM is used to study the insights of the sample. However, broadly comparing the two, SEM is affordable and easier technology. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed learning. See you in next video.